Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Blazor drop-down list of Synfusion. Imagine that you are about to answer a poll question that asks you to tell your favorite sports name. In this case, you would like to select a name from the list of selectable items instead of manually typing in the values. Here comes the Blazor drop-down list of Synfusion, which helps you to choose an item from a huge collection and display that selected item on the UI. Also, I can bind hierarchical data, do filtering, grouping, UI customization with templates, as well as can create a cascading drop-down list. First, I will start with the Blazor application creation process. For that, I need to make sure whether .NET Core SDK 3.1.2 or later versions are installed in my machine, and I should have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 to create a Blazor application. Now, I'm going to create a new server-side Blazor app. So, let me open the Visual Studio 2019 first and create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I will choose Blazor app and click Next to proceed further with the project creation. Here, I will name my project as Blazor Example and click the Create button. Next, I will choose this Blazor Server App option and click this Create button finally to complete the project creation. Now, the project has been created and ready to use. If you want to know more about the Blazor Server App and how to add Synfusion components to it, then you can listen to the video link that is shown in the above YouTube card. Now, I will tell you the steps to add Blazor drop-down list. To start using the Synfusion Blazor drop-down list, first I need to install the Synfusion Blazor NuGet package into my application. For that, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choose the option Manage NuGet Packages. Here, I need to enable this Include Pre-release checkbox, as I'm going to use the beta version of Synfusion Blazor package. Then, I will search for Synfusion Blazor in Browse tab and install it into my project. Once the installation gets completed, let me navigate to imports.razor file, and here, I will add Synfusion Blazor dropdowns namespace to start using the Blazor dropdown list in any of the components available under the Pages folder. Next, I will open the startup.cs file. Here, I need to add the Synfusion Blazor namespace, and then I will register the Synfusion Blazor service by calling a method addSynfusionBlazor within the configureServices method. Also, I should register valid license key of the Essential Studio into my application. So, let me register the trial license key using the registerLicense method. The next important thing is, I need to define the CSS for drop-down list. Therefore, let me navigate to host.cshtml file under the Pages folder to refer the CSS file from the installed Synfusion Blazor package. Now, everything is configured, so let me proceed to add the Blazor drop-down list. For that, I need to open the index.razor component, and here, I will include the drop-down list component by replacing the default code. Next, I will start to populate the data for the drop-down list. So, first I need to create a code block. Here, I have planned to display the sports name in the drop-down list. Therefore, let me define a model class games data with two fields, namely name and ID. Then, I will create a list games of type games data and assigned an array of objects to it. To this drop-down list, I need to specify the data source type. So, let me define a property tItem and set its value as games data. Then, I also need to specify the drop-down list value field type. So, I will define the property tValue and set its value as string. Now, I will assign this object games to the data source property of the drop-down list. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the drop-down list component. So, I need to define the drop-down list field settings tag and map the data source fields name to text property and ID to value property. Here, this data source contains a list of sports. So, let me define the property placeholder with the value select a game, which will be displayed in the drop-down list component as description. Now, I will run this example by pressing the key F5. When you look at the Blazer drop-down list, you can see the sports name listed here. You can also notice that the drop-down list displays a short description as select a game. Here, by default, the pop-up width will automatically adjust according to the drop-down list input elements width, and default height will be 350 pixel. So, if I would like to set custom height and width to the pop-up, then inside the drop-down list code, I need to define the pop-up width and pop-up height properties with custom values. So here, look at the drop-down list component where the pop-up is displayed with custom height and width. Suppose, if I want to bind a remote data source to Blazer drop-down list, then I can bind it using the data manager component of Synfusion, which acts as a gateway between the drop-down list and data source and also uses queries to interact with both the local and remote data source. So, as a first step, I will navigate to imports.racer file and import the namespace Synfusion Blazer data to use data manager component. Then, I need to include the Synfusion data manager component and define the properties URL, adapter, and cross domain. In the URL, I will be using the already available remote URL service, which will retrieve the list of data through post action and bind the resultant data to the drop-down list. Also, I have set the web API adapter here as the URL is assigned with the existing web API service. And the cross-domain option is set to true to allow the cross-origin domain request. Since I have defined the data manager component here, therefore, let me remove the data source property from the drop-down list code. Here, this remote URL contains four fields: employee ID, first name, designation, and country. To access this remote URL fields, first I need to create a model class employee data and define the fields employee ID, first name, designation, and country. Now, I need to map the remote data source fields. So, I will map first name to the text property and employee ID to value property. As I have set employee names as data source, so let me change the placeholder property value as select a name. Also, I need to replace the T item value as employee data, as I'm going to bind this employee data model class to the drop-down list. So here, you can see the drop-down list which shows employee names over here. Let me summarize some of the important points now. We have seen how to add the Blazer drop-down list of Synfusion to the Blazer application. Also, we have seen how to populate remote data source to the drop-down list and how to set custom height and width for the drop-down list pop-up. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use a complete Blazer products if you fit into a community guidelines. So, check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using a community license. Also, if you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.